The Magic Man, once again, I'm still on the court. The lights stayed on. I thought they was gonna go off when I did the other video. Let me see if I can bust another video very quickly. So Federer, he ain't tripping. Nadal fans tripping. Federer fans tripping. Other tennis fans tripping. But Federer ain't tripping. I'm telling you. Man, tennis preacher prophet, the psychic, coming back at you again, and the tennis pastor coming back at you again with another video. Yeah, people, let me just tell y'all, I don't care what y'all say. Y'all can come back and comment, which y'all can comment good. This whole defending point system that the ATP got, this is stupid, people. Listen, this system is not that's not a good system to me. Now, I'm talking about that part. And let me tell y'all why. Okay, I'm a prude to y'all that this ain't really a good system. And I'm not saying this to defend Federer. I'm saying even Nadal. Nadal having to defend what he did last year. What has last year got to do with this year? Okay, now people, let's take in boxing. And people, I'm a big boxing fan, okay? People, okay, in boxing, they say you defend your title. Okay, so if you, okay, so say a Muhammad Ali steps into the ring with his belt on, to defend the belt, his world championship belt. So if when Muhammad Ali beats the guy, his opponent, defeats his opponent, he keeps his belt. He doesn't get a new belt, okay? Now, you may say, what has that got to do with tennis? Okay, listen, people. The tennis system, this whole defending points in tennis is silly. Because here's the deal. Let's take Cilic. Cilic won the U.S. Open, right? He was awarded prize money, and then he was awarded a trophy, a cup, a U.S. Open cup. It's his. He doesn't have to bring that cup back to defend it. It's his. Even if Cilic doesn't show up at the U.S. Open the next year, that cup is his. Okay, people? So I believe points should be the same way. Why does he have to defend the points from last year? Listen, this whole thing is silly, people. Okay, so let's take Federer, for example. Federer won the Wimbledon last year. He was awarded prize money for that victory in 2017. He was awarded his eighth Wimbledon Cup trophy. It's his in his house. He don't have to bring it back this year. So here's my deal. If you're giving him a cup, a trophy that he doesn't have to bring back. Also, Wikipedia has put in the Wikipedia statistics that Federer is now an 8-time Wimbledon champion. Okay, if he loses in the Wimbledon this year, he won't become a 7-time. They're not going to take it away from him. So why are they taking points away? Why does he have to defend points for something he did last year? He's already done that. He's been paid for it. He's been given a trophy for it. Same thing with Nadal. Nadal won his 10th French Open. They awarded him prize money. They awarded him a French Open trophy cup. Okay, Nadal went home, put it in his trophy case. It's there now. So Nadal shows up at the French Open this year. He doesn't have to do, see, in boxing, if that was boxing, Nadal would have to bring back that French Open trophy and defend it. But Nadal doesn't have to bring back the trophy to defend it. It's his. Also, in Wikipedia, they has put down that Nadal has won 10 French Opens. You cannot take that away from the Nadal. You cannot take that away from Nadal. But so why is it then you're not going to take the trophy away? You're not going to take the statistic away of Nadal winning 10 French Opens. It's in the history books. But you're going to take away the 2,000 points if he doesn't show up to what y'all call defending. See, I disagree with that whole, I wish they get rid of that silly nonsense defending system. All right? And You know, I want to bring this up here. You know, I want to take away from the topic of the defending points that I just made. But people, I actually agree with this here. I just taking Google and see what people were saying. A lot of people think they should bring back the bonus points. Bonus points mean, like, let's say if you number 10 in the world, right? And let's say in the finals, you beat, okay, let's say in the finals, you beat maybe Chilich. So you may not get any bonus points for that. But if you beat a Federer or a Nadal or a top the Djokovic or whoever's number one in the world, you would get 100 bonus points in addition to the 2,000 points you would get for winning the French Open or the Wimbledon or whatever the slam is. I should agree with that right there. That makes sense to me. But this defending points, man, you know, y'all can come back and comment and tell me, you know, maybe I'm missing something. But I'm just saying, I don't think, and if they trying to, you know, I understand they may not want points to accumulate to the next year. Okay then, but then you can just say you lose your points at the end of the year. But that's different than defending points. Yeah, so like I said before, this ain't like boxing. If they going to let you keep the trophy, if they going to let you keep the cup, the trophy, take it home, secure it in your house forever, If you are able to keep that statistic that you won the French Open last year, then why do you have to, why are you going to lose the points then? Why are you going to lose 2,000 points if you don't play or whatever amount of points if you lose in quarterfinals or whatever? So I don't like that. I don't like the defending system, okay? And that's, I mean, I know that's my opinion, but I don't like it. And there's other reasons about it why I don't like it. It may not really tell who the number one person is to sometime here, you know. Now I know some people may say, well, it's a they may say, I know it puts a lot of pressure on you, and some people may think that's good. And I mean, y'all know me, I like the tough thing, but I don't like that. If you already won something last year, you did it, you had a good year, and so this year should have nothing to do with last year. Okay, people, y'all can tell me what y'all think. Comment below. Tennis Preacher Prophet Psychic signing off. Have a good one.